نشكره ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Verily the praise belongs to Allah. We praise Him, seek His assistance and forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of ourselves and the evil consequences of our deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is no one that can lead him astray. And whoever Allah leads astray, there is no one that can guide him. I bear witness that nothing deserves to be worshipped except Allah alone, and that He has no partners or associates. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave servant and his messenger. This morning, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we would like to continue in the series of lectures dealing with the brief explanation of the evidences of the shurut of La ilaha illallah. Adillatu La ilaha illallah. Shurut, adillatu shurut of La ilaha illallah. And these evidences are taken from the essay of Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, with a brief explanation from Shaykh Ubaid al-Jabiri, Allah yahfadhu. In the previous lecture, we have mentioned three of the shurut of La ilaha illallah, al-ilm wal-yaqeen wal-ikhlas. Al-ilm, the knowledge, and it means the knowledge of the meaning of La ilaha illallah, what it negates and what it confirms, that it negates worship for other than Allah, and confirms that worship is for Allah alone. As for al-yaqeen, it is kamal al-ilm, the perfection of knowledge, yani knowledge to its fullest extent, after which there is no doubt, there is no shak or ray. Naam. As for the third condition of La ilaha illallah, that is al-ikhlas. Al-ikhlas, it is the opposite of shirk. Yani of the conditions or the shurut of La ilaha illallah is that a person has to make this statement or pronouncement or confession, making that statement purely for the sake of Allah alone without associating anyone in it, yani avoiding shirk. The fourth condition or shart of La ilaha illallah, the fourth condition of La ilaha illallah, it is al-sidq al-munafi lil-kadhib wal-mani' min al-nifaq. Yani the fourth condition is al-sidq or truthfulness, that the person should make this pronouncement or this confession or testimony truthfully. That sidq which negates lying and which prohibits hypocrisy, it prevents hypocrisy. If the person is truthful in their statement of La ilaha illallah, then they would have avoided lying, and they also will have avoided hypocrisy and nifaq, because they have said it out of truthfulness and sincerity. Then the Shaykh mentions, Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab mentions three evidences, two verses of the Quran and a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first of those evidences, he said, دليل الصدق قوله تعالى. The evidence for this condition of al-sidq or truthfulness, it is the saying of Allah in Surah Al-Ankabut, chapter 29, verses 1-3. Alif Lam Mim. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَقُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. The saying of Allah, Alif Lam Mim, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَقُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. And do the people think that they will be left alone or upon saying that we believe would they be left alone on just saying from their tongue that we believe and that they would not be tested after that? لَقَدَ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Indeed, we have tested and tried those who were before them, the believers in the previous prophets. When they claimed to believe in Allah, then they were tested with trials and tribulations to confirm the correctness and the legitimacy of their claim of Iman. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. And through these tests and trials, through the tests and trials, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make known, He will bring forth the manifestation of those who are truthful in their statement of La ilaha illallah and those who are kathibeen, kathib, lying. As sidq, it removes lying. The one who is truthful will not be a liar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests the one who says La ilaha illallah in order to manifest and to bring out so it will be known to others. While Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already knows without testing them who from amongst them are truthful and who from amongst them are lying. The second evidence that Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab mentions is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verses 8 and 9, or 8 and 9 and 10. The saying of Allah, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. That from amongst the people are those who say by their tongue, we believe in Allah in the last day. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ, from amongst the people there are some, مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. They say that they believe in Allah in the last day, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala negates their iman. He says, وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ, but they are not believers. And this is the case of the hypocrites who say, لا إله إلا الله, but not with صدق, not truthfully, but كذب, lying. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says concerning them, يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, that they seek to deceive Allah and those who believe. وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ, but they do not deceive anyone except their own selves. وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ, and they do not deceive, they are not aware. They seek to deceive Allah by the false lying profession of La ilaha illallah, while it is not in their heart the iman that supports it. They seek to deceive Allah and those who believe by their statement, but they only deceive themselves while they are not aware that the deception is only falling on themselves. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ, that in their hearts is a disease, the disease of hypocrisy and nifaq. They claim on their tongue to believe while in their heart there is kufr. This is nifaq, hypocrisy, the one who claims to believe while in the heart they do not believe. فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ, in their hearts is a disease, hypocrisy and doubt. فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا, so Allah increased their disease. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ, and for them is a terrible punishment because of their lying. Because of their lying when they claimed to believe, they were lying. It was كذب. It was not صدق. It was not truthfulness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end of this verse says that they have a disease in their heart because of their hypocrisy. Then Allah in this world punishes them by increasing their disease. And this is based on the principle that the Shaykh mentions in the Sharh, that the action or the sin or the crime that a person commits would be rewarded and equally or similarly. Al-jaza'u min jins al-amal. Al-jaza', the reward or recompense for one's action, min jins al-amal, will be similar to the deed that one has done. Whoever has done good, then Allah will reward them with good. And whoever has done evil, Allah will reward them with evil. Here also in this verse there is the mention of their punishment in the next life, and that is عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ, a terrible punishment because they used to lie. As for the evidence from the Sunnah, Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he says, وَمِنَ السُنَّةِ